Hi, this is Mark Malberg, and in this OmniSurf demonstration, we're going to take a look at the ability to measure the groove depth of a standard roughness specimen. In this case, we have a three-line specimen, and we want to level the profile on both sides of these grooves and calculate the depth of the central groove. So let's go ahead and use our cursors for this task, and I'll pull the vertical ones out of the way and drop a cursor here. We'll zero that position and find out how wide these grooves are. It's about 0.6 millimeters wide. So if I back this one off 0.6, it's already zeroed. So there's negative 0.6. Let's zero this location and pull over 0.6. And we should now see that we have a central region which takes up one third of our valid length and then another third on each side. So let's compute between the X cursors and take a look at the primary profile. Now in this case, the profile may not be perfectly level. The grooves were part of the leveling process. So let's use our cursors again. And this time we'll block off those grooves and say compute excluding between the cursors. This excluding occurs during the form removal. So those grooves, which are now hashed out with a hash mark in a different direction, those are excluded when we fit a line to level the data. So this data is now leveled based on the white background here and the white background here. Now there's a new feature in version 3.08 of OmniSurf. This new feature is such that if I set a cursor zero position, that zero position sticks. If I zoom in and then put my cursors back on, it's still zero. In versions prior to 3.08, the cursor would reset its zero anytime we zoomed. But this new ability to lock that cursor zero is going to be quite interesting, because as you'll see, we can now zoom in on the bottom of that valley and we can put our cursors back on the data and run a line through the middle of that base of that valley and see the depth of negative 2.237 micrometers below the zero point that we set. We can tell that that's the zero point that we set because it's negative 2.237, and the bottom of the graph itself relative to zero, the absolute coordinate zero, is negative 2.1, but relative to our peaks we see a depth of 2.237. So let's hold that thought for a second and zoom all the way back out, and we'll see here's a zero. We can confirm that our zero was indeed up here and that the valley that we were measuring is in the negative 2.2 realm, and we were able to get much more accurate when we zoom in. So this ability to zoom in on a feature and not lose our cursor zero is something new in OmniSurf version 3.08, and it's something that should be very useful in the calibration of depths of specimens. Thanks.